It's so funny, whenever we go out to a restaurant or wherever we're having a meal with somebody, the thing that we most often talk about is what are we gonna eat next, right? So food is such a good conversation piece.
Mm-hmm. And now we can finish.
What if that conversation turned into an event and then a business? People have been gathering for meals as long as there's been civilization.
And this evening, the Buckley Report shows us how some food lovers here in the Piedmont Triad plan to use the concepts of great food and conversation into more than just a new restaurant. They plan to provide a memorable experience.
Food used to be just for survival. You had to go hunt what you wanted to eat just to live. We now see it as this item where we can get together and we can have a communal experience and we can share food with others.
Community was at the heart of Tal Blevins' move home.
I had the opportunity in my former life as a tech journalist to travel around the world, go to Japan, go to Germany, go to France, eat at restaurants all around the world, and had a real passion for food and bev.
So when Tal and his wife, Nicole, moved from San Francisco back to his hometown of Greensboro for a more communal experience, they knew food should be at the heart of it. And when they were eating at the restaurant where Chef Kevin Cottrell worked,
just happened to go out and ask, you know, how his meal was one night, and I love the way that he talked about food.
They turned their shared passion into Machete Meals, sort of a traveling supper club of spectacular 9 or 10 course meals that they'll prepare in your or their home.
This isn't so much food as it is art.
Yeah. It's kind of like art on a plate. We use modern cooking techniques, but all those modern cooking techniques that we use, it's always to enhance the flavor of the food.
The menus always have something interesting.
We have beef cheeks in the smoker right now. Yeah. To me, it's like better than a brisket.
But it's not snob food.
We're doing a grilled romaine, head of romaine for a play on a Caesar salad that we're doing, which is going to be interesting.
Machete Meals.
Yeah, we find a way to drag this grill out for every dinner, so.
That's good, I love it.
Is simply exploring food beyond the typical fare.
We always like to say we're a farm-to-table concept, but that farm could be somewhere in South America, right? If we want a really nice pepper from that farm, we want to get it, right? We want to introduce new flavors to it, but we want to do it in a very approachable way.
We like to do nostalgia with all of our food, but specifically desserts, and so we're doing a play on s'mores.
To say the idea is en fuego.
Huge, huge response from these dinners.
Would be a Spanish language understatement.
It's insane. Like, it's completely blown up. It's like, it's the coolest date night in town because it's like, this is the place to be twice a month. And people kind of have that, like, did you get in? No. I got in. We have a chocolate sauce that we shoved in a whipped cream charger and aerated.
The response has been enthusiastic enough that they feel there's a real taste for this food in the Triad.
It's that they just really haven't had the opportunity to have that here. So, you know, they go to New York or they go to Chicago or they go to New Orleans or San Francisco and have these amazing meals. Why not be able to have something like that right at home?
You kind of like, you one-upped on the s'mores thing because you included the campfire and the flavor.
Which means Machete may cut a new path inside its own permanent location.
The goal is to really open up a restaurant here in Greensboro. We want to share this with people and what we're doing.
Creating some community.
And through food, that's a great way to do that.
Bob Buckley, Fox 8 News.
And if you want to know more about the concept